Hello everybody, welcome back in today's video. Speaking about our post-processing, many people want the best image quality for RAW photos like me. And for this reason, all cameras manufacturers give us the chance to use RAW files instead of only JPEG, or maybe JPEG plus RAW. But are they all good? Let's go to discover. Hello guys, for those who don't know me, my name is Giuseppe and I'm an Italian nature and wildlife photographer. In today's video, I want to analyze two kinds of RAW files, the compressed RAW and the uncompressed RAW file of the Sony A9, just to understand which is the best and mostly to figure out when you can use them and in which situation they are suitable. The Sony A9 can store images in three different ways: RAW, RAW plus JPEG and JPEG. Leaving the last two options, in the RAW option you can set between compressed and uncompressed RAW files. But what does it mean? Okay, the compressed RAW files are got using only 12 bits instead of 14 bits in compressed RAW files. During a digital conversion of an analog source, images, sounds or whatever you want, you have to use a certain amount of bits per pixel if we speak about images. The smallest digital information to map your analog source. The more bits you use, the more quality you get. Using 12 bits means that every single color channel RGB of a sensor can reproduce more than 4000 different tonal colors for that single channel. Using 14 bits, you can get more 16,000 different tonal colors, so 3 times bigger than using 12 bits. And this makes our images more realistic in terms of color reproduction with more shades. Okay, and after this boring theory, it's time to start the test. Now I'm going to take different pictures, first using the compressed RAW and after using the uncompressed RAW option. For the two situations, I'm going to take pictures at different exposition values. So, for instance, the first one at normal exposition, the second one underexposing of one stop, the third one underexposing of two stops, and so on, until 3 stops. The test will be taken into my house in order to have always the same light condition and subject. Oh yes, I don't want to risk my subject fly away during the test. So let's crack on. I've uploaded them, the picture in the computer. Okay, now I'm using Lightroom just for the downloading the images and to make the first adjustment. I mean, moving the slider of the shadows and the blacks all on the right. And this is the first picture taken in compressed mode and without any exposition compensation. The second one has been taken lowering of one stop the exposition. The second one of two stops, and the third one of three stops. So the first four pictures have taken in compressed mode. The second part of the picture have been taken in uncompressed mode. So this is the last one, which I've already moved the cursor of the shadows and the blacks on the right. But let's see the images using Photoshop. Okay, this one is the first picture in compressed mode at 100 ISO and without any exposition compensation. As you can see, the picture is pretty good. Oh, I would say it's perfect. The images has been magnified of 200% in order to see every aspect of the image. The second one is the same picture but in uncompressed mode, and we can I want to okay, 60, 70, 76 in this way and in this way. In theory, okay, we can compare together the two pictures. It's pretty clear that there is no difference in terms of image quality, because the two different images, so the compressed one and the uncompressed one, are perfectly equal. These are the darkest part of the image, like this one, and they are the same. So there is no, there aren't no differences. Now we are going to check the three stop underexposed picture. This one is the compressed raw, and this one is the compressed raw, and this one is the uncompressed raw. The only difference that we can notice is here, that in the uncompressed raw is a little bit different, but not so much. The compressed raw has a better management of the darkest area. instead of the compressed uncompressed raw, but it looks like with the grain, with the noise, a little bit more evident. Okay, but we are also speaking with an image that has free stop of underexposition, that in general we don't use normally. Okay. Okay, as you can see, there aren't significant differences between the two kind of raw file. They are more or less equivalent. In the last example, I mean with the free stop of underexposition, there are small differences in terms of grain and chromatic noise in dark areas of the images. Okay, speaking about size, the compressed raw file are about 24 megapixels instead of 37 megapixels of uncompressed raw file. That can be a reason to go for compressed file because it allows you to save space in your hard drive computer and in the memory card of the camera. Another aspect to consider is the shooting bars of the Sony A9. The maximum continuous shooting at 20 fps is achievable only using compressed RAW files, so at 12 bits, whereas with uncompressed file at 14 bits, you can get only 12 fps. That can be quite enough for many of us. Very well guys, it's time to come to a conclusion. Actually, there aren't big differences in terms of image quality between compressed and uncompressed RAW files. So, you might use your camera always in compressed mode in order to have always 20 fps, but in wildlife photography is an excellent tip. But if you aren't a wildlife photographer, or maybe you take always pictures of static subjects, it doesn't matter having 20 fps. And with only 12 fps, you can grab your images with the maximum quality as well. And you can also save space on your computers. That's always good. Of course, if you are a different photographer, maybe a fashion photographer, so it's better to go for the best quality. So using 14 bits RAW files. Okay guys, I hope being useful with this short video. In case, I'd appreciate if you subscribe to my channel in order to support me always more. And not forget to allow the notification bell. So for now, it's all. See you in the next video. Take care.